And Richard Southern joins us now. Richard, the Ontario government is considering giving the green light to cannabis lounges.
Yeah, places where you can go and smoke. Because as you know, Christina, you can't smoke inside anywhere here in Ontario.
Right.
But the Ford government today says it's looking at the possibility of cannabis lounges, so-called consumption venues, as they put it, whereby you can go and, you know, toke to your heart's content. They also talked about the possibility of special occasion permits that would allow outdoor festivals and concerts to have an area where you can legally smoke cannabis. Now, the government says it's going to open public consultations on this. There's no timeline just yet. But when it comes to these cafes, I mean, you know, if you've ever been to Amsterdam, you kind of know what they may look like. And would obviously, I think, Christina, be good for tourism, one would imagine. And when it comes to those outdoor festivals, people are smoking cannabis anyways. Maybe it'd be a good idea to have them in a regulated spot, don't you think?
Well, I mean, even in concerts that are inside, I think we've all smelled the, smelled
marijuana. What's that smell?
Yeah, exactly. You know, got that?
It happens, so I mean, it might be a good idea to regulate it. And you know, if you, one would imagine, the indoor ones might be just vaping only, which is much less smoky for an inside environment. So it'll be interesting to see what the government comes out with.
Well, it'll be interesting to see what the consultings come out with. Okay, well, we've all been there, stuck in traffic with drivers laying on the horn all around us. One major city is taking some extreme steps to stop that behavior. Richard, tell me about this.
I thought this was interesting. This is a video they put. This is Mumbai, India, where now they've installed devices on the traffic lights, Christina. The more you honk, the longer they stay red. What a way to deter the honking. If the meters register a noise level above 85 decibels, the lights just keep on showing red. Mumbai was recently ranked as the fourth most congested city in the world. Drivers there last year lost 8 days to being stuck in traffic. The idea, which was, they put this out actually in December, and it's worked so well, they're talking about bringing it to more cities. Maybe we got to think outside the box as far as how to get our congestion straightened out, Christina.
Well, I'm trying to figure out how they can determine, like, if it's the north and southbound people that are honking or the east and westbound. So that's some pretty high-tech stuff there.
Like, listen, everybody's got to be quiet or we're not going to get to work today.
Pretty much. A new cat has stolen the hearts of Instagram users around the world. I love pet stories, so tell me about this.
His name, look at him.
Aww.
His name's Belarus. He's in San Francisco. He's got 250,000 Instagram followers because, look, he's cross-eyed. He has an eye condition which causes him to look this way. However, it's not painful. It doesn't impair his vision. His owner, Rachel, got him from a shelter because she thought he was so cute. And everyone online has just fallen in love with him. And his owner as well, Christina, has started selling shirts and hoodies with his picture on, and 100% of the profits go to animal shelters. So it's a good story all around. Look at him.
Very, very cute, and I'm a little bit biased because I am slightly cross-eyed, especially when I'm tired, so I think cross-eyed is just adorable. Let's go with that.
I think so. He's cute.
Thanks, Richard. Thanks so much for joining us. I'll see you tomorrow.
Cheers.